Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. Today I'm happy to join the blog hop of Altenew featuring new products and I will share two cards using the rose filament dies. And as you can see, it is packed with dies of different sizes and designs of roses and I just love how they cut out the flower and I'm going to show you two different ways on how you can use that. And I am combining words from this die set which is called Script Words Die. Now for my first card, I'm going for a very elegant and sophisticated looking card, which is going to be great for anniversaries and even weddings. So I'm going to use this gold cardstock by Tim Holtz and I'm going to cut out some of the roses as well as the word love. After running everything through my Big Shot, you can see how beautiful those roses look. So the design of this card is super quick and easy. All I'm going to do is to cover up a piece of white cardstock with all those designs. So first of all, I'm going to run through the sentiment from my sticker maker. And you see that I managed to run the word love through my sticker maker since it's quite narrow, but I will have to use my white glue at the back of the rest of the flowers. Now, as you can see, I am using my Nouveau Deluxe glue there and I really like it because it doesn't clog. I don't know how that happens, but it's never clogged and I like how the tip is nice and fine, perfect for application of glue in such tiny little areas. Now, I'm going to go ahead and stick all those flowers all over the white panel. And as I'm sticking everything down, I don't mind if some of those roses extend the white area. Now my background is ready, I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the excess of all those flowers that go outside of my panel. So I have everything nice and neat. Now just because this is gold, it's super shiny and so elegant looking, I don't think that you need to do a lot on top of that. So all I'm going to do is to back up this panel with a piece of gold cardstock. So I will have a gold border around my panel. And I used foam tape at the back to stick those pieces together, so I do end up having a little bit of dimension. And this is a great design to mass produce because all you have to do is to do all the die cutting at first, then spray with some spray adhesive and then stick them on top of panels. Super quick and easy with a beautiful outcome. Now I'm going to make another card using the same rose dies. So I will bring in my Big Shot machine. I'm going to bring in my plates there. And this time I'm going to cut out the flower from white cardstock. So I am going to cut this out twice since I need two of those. And as you can see, once I pass them through, I will make sure that I will not separate the inside pieces. So I'm going to remove this flower very carefully and I'm going to place this on one side and then I'm going to cut it once more. And since I have my Big Shot out, I will go ahead and cut out my sentiment. So I'm using the script word that says hugs and I'm going to cut it out from black cardstock. So notice how I am going to flip this at the back, making sure that I am not popping out all those inside pieces. I want to keep them since I will use them on the finished card. Now at the back I'm using some masking tape and this way I'm going to keep everything together. And on the front I'm going to do some inking. As you can see, I'm planning to use my distress inks with finger dabbers, so I'm going to mask off a little bit of the rose so that I don't accidentally touch up the rose and it ends up green. I am first going to color the leaves, as you can see, so I am applying some ink all over the leaves, making sure that I am going to cover them up completely. And then I'm going to remove the masking tape and place it on top of my leaves to protect the leaves this time, since I'm going to bring in distress inks for coloring the rose. Again, I'm going to use two shades, a lighter and a darker one. And as you can see, I did use only the lighter green for the leaves, and now I'm using only the lighter pink for the rose. You will find links to the exact color, name colors of ink pads that I used down below in the description area. as well as everything that I always link down there. Now I'm going to pop out the main design, so you see that as I remove it, I make sure that everything else is stuck down there, so that I don't lose any piece. And now on this piece that I have, I am going to go ahead and do again inking, but this time I'm going with a darker ink. So when I place this on top of the other pieces, you will see the difference later on. So I'm going to do the same thing for the leaves with a darker green, and I will end up having a darker outline for my leaves. I'm going to place that on top so you can see how it looks now. Now I have another rose that I have cut out previously, and I want this just because I want to stick the rose that I have colored on top of that. This is just going to make my focal point a little bit thicker, so that it looks as if it's a chipboard element, which is going to give more dimension on the front of my card. And to stick those pieces together, again I'm going to use my Nuvo Deluxe fine tip glue. When you are trying to stick two pieces that are so intricate together, it's always nice to use white glue, because it gives you some movement, so that you can slide one on top of the other until you are happy with how they align. Now my focal point is ready. I am adding some white glue at the back, and then I'm going to stick it on a piece of white panel. And since I have already cut out my sentiment, I'm going to just place it there, just to make sure that I have enough space at the bottom of my panel to stick the word hugs later on. And I hope you can see here how thick this element is. It's nice and dimensional, and that's just because I stuck two cardstock together, one on top of the other. And now I'm going to add some glue on the white spaces, and then place all those little pieces inside. A great thing is that I have them all stuck on top of post-it tape, which means that I know where everything goes, and also I haven't lost any piece. Now, just because the outline of the rose is two layers, while the inside little pieces are just one layer, they are going to fall just inside, which is going to give an extra dimension on my element. Now, before I stick down my word hugs, I wanted to create some splashes, and before I do the splatter there, I needed to cover up my rose somehow, so I don't mess it up. So just I'm using a scrap piece of paper here, and I'm cutting it out following the lines of the die. So I'm going to place that on top. This is not a sticky paper, this is just a scrap piece of printer paper. I am going to bring in some black gesso, but you can use any black acrylic paint here, dilute it with water, and then do the splashes. I like to do any splattering with a thin brush, just because this way I know that I end up having very thin splashes, as you can see here on my scrap paper. Now, if you are wondering why I decided to do that as a part of my design, is just because I have too much of a white space, and at the same time I want to stick on top a black sentiment, and I think that a few black splashes really bring everything together. Now I am sticking down the word hugs, and again I used my white glue at the back. Now based on the colors that we already have on top of our panel, you can use a pink card base, you can use a white card base, or even a light green one. Now I decided to go and stick that on top of a white card base, but I want to bring that pink a little bit more, and that's why I am matting this panel with a piece of pink cardstock. And then finally I'm going to stick this panel on top of my card base by using some foam tape at the back. And these were the cards that I made for today's blog hop featuring Alte New products. Don't forget to visit my blog, because there is a giveaway waiting for you there, and you will find details on the blog hop and on more giveaways along the way. Thank you all for watching, and see you next time!